Come Saturday morning, I'm away with my friend. Will Saturday spend till the end of the day? Just I and my friend. We'll travel for miles in our Saturday smiles, and then we'll move on. But we will remember long after Saturday's gone.
Every football team in the nation strives for the right combination to give it the ultimate conquest. Wyoming is no exception. The Cowboy coaching staff ranges the nation in search of the finest student athletes. Many are attracted by the beautiful campus and the keen competition offered by the Western Athletic Conference. An in-depth look at the Cowboys points out the unique attitude of these young men and how much more there is to the game than merely playing it. Eight players from the 1974 team typify the attitude of the entire squad and what it means to play football at the University of Wyoming. These, then, are the Wyoming Cowboys on the road to conquest.
Just I and my friend.
We have a good outlook on things this year for Wyoming. We have a good team, we have a lot of skill, a lot of depth this year also. The guys are all very close together. We all like each other. We all have a good time together, go to classes together, eat together, we room together. We don't share girlfriends really, but we have a good time doing a lot of things. It makes a lot of things easier when you have your best friends on the team and you just have a really good time with them. There's no dissension at all. It's a good feeling just being around all those guys, knowing that they're your best friends.
Joe Marion, number 48, is one of the top punters in the nation. The kicking game always has been a vital part of the Wyoming system. But Marion fills a dual role. He is the starting right linebacker. This is a change of emphasis for the Polk staff. In the past, the kicker was a specialist. No more. He must know what it's like to hit and be hit. Marion, a junior biology major from Rochester, New York, plays the position with proficiency. Number 32 is Al Dine, the bullet of the Wyoming secondary. Hal, the tri-captain of the 74 Pokes, earned his nickname by his slashing play at safety for two seasons. This fall, he made the switch to cornerback easily. He has learned the importance of maturity during a game.
In order to play a good game, you have to be emotionally ready. Now, in order to get emotionally ready, you have to really hustle and practice that whole week, and you have to watch a lot of film, and that'll get the whole team ready. It'll give the whole team that emotional edge. Now, this emotional edge can be kind of dangerous. You got to watch out that you don't get so emotionally up that you make mistakes in the game because you're just not thinking. This will run into big plays. Now, if you're really emotionally ready, you'll make the big plays, and that's what football is all about. To make the big play. It makes you proud of yourself as a football player, it makes your teammates proud of you. And that's the thing that really makes a team, is when your teammates really believe in you.
Leads by doing. He plays the cornerback position with reckless abandon. The battle for a starting position on any football team is always intense. For an 18-year-old just out of high school to challenge for a quarterback's job on a major college team, well, the pressure is almost overpowering. But Rick Costello of La Mirada, California, met that challenge with a poise that belied his years. He won his spurs in the supercharged atmosphere at Texas. He started his first game a week later and guided the Cowboys to a victory over the Air Force.
As a freshman, I had two major obstacles to overcome in my quest for a starting quarterback position: demonstrating my ability to the team and coaches, and secondly, maintaining a positive mental attitude. If you don't have a good day, you have to forget it and come back the next day and try a little harder. One of the biggest things I live with daily is proving myself each week. I need to better myself every game or I know I will not keep my starting position. It was my goal to come here and gain the starting quarterback position, which I've done. I personally feel it's a great honor and a constant challenge.
He learned the hard way. And each game he improved and gained the vast experience needed to become a first-ranked quarterback and vie for Rookie of the Year honors in the WAC. Costello demonstrated he could throw, and run. And direct the Cowboy offense. The solid veteran at tight end was John Dunn, number 81. Dunn, a senior from Placentia, California, continued his consistent performance afield and in the classroom. He prepared for a game as methodically as he prepared for a career in law.
The best way I've found to prepare for a game is through the art of visualization. By this, I mean I play the game over in my head maybe two or three times before I even step on the field. I visualize myself coming off the ball, being quick on double teams, coming off the ball on my pass routes, catching the ball, anything any situation that might arise in a football game, I've at least thought over once or twice. For me to play a good game, I found that I have to practice this art of visualization, be prepared mentally as well as physically throughout the ball game.
One of the top scholar athletes at Wyoming, Dunn earned Western Athletic Conference All-Academic Honors for 2 years. The summer before his senior year, he was selected to serve as an intern in the office of U.S. Senator Gail McGee. John was one of the favorite targets of quarterback Rick Costello.
Taping of the ankles, number one, is to prevent ankle injuries. Second is to give them a little more support. I think getting my ankles taped is a good thing here at the University of Wyoming because, as I recall, when I was in high school, I had ankle problems, you know, and I was out for a couple of games. But since I've been here at the university, we have some good trainers here, and they do a good job of taping our ankles for us and, you know, getting us ready to play for Saturday. And you know, I've enjoyed playing football here at the university, playing wide receiver. And, you know, when I come out on Saturday, you know, I try to rid my mind of all the external factors that could possibly interfere with my concentration on playing the game, catching the ball and so forth. You know, I try to center all my mind on doing my job and try to do it the best of my God-given ability.
A veteran as a sophomore, that's Doug Wilson, number 28 of Osceola, Arkansas, who became a starter as a freshman in 1973. He combined good speed and sure hands to become the Cowboys' leading receiver in 1974. He also was a threat as a runner from his flanker position, adding another dimension to the Wyoming ground attack. With 2 years remaining, Doug could be one of the all-time leading pass receivers in Polk history.
When I come out of the huddle, I look at the defensive back and I look at the coverage. Then I think about what pattern I'm going to run. And I think about the snap count. I think about the pass that I'm going to run on the situation, what defense they're going to be running. Am I going to run a curl or out or a bend? Am I running my pattern correctly? Am I running fast enough? If the pattern is a curl, beat the linebacker to the inside. If the pattern's out, beat the corner. Relax, catch the ball. Concentrate on the ball. Catch the ball. Do everything you can to score. Your teammates are counting on you to catch the ball, and that's the main thing. That's what your big thoughts are.
The potential game breaker for 3 years was split end Archie Gray, number 17. The Omaha, Nebraska senior carted away the vast majority of Wyoming pass receiving records. Archie has had the ability to catch the ball in a crowd and to run with it.
Mm-hmm.
man who most typified the scholar-athlete concept of intercollegiate sports was Mike LoPiccolo, senior tri-captain from Denver, Colorado. A three-year starter at offensive tackle, Mike consistently graded 90% or better over that span. In addition, his consistency in the classroom earned him academic All-American First Team and WAC All-Academic Honors. Mike realizes the importance of both football and academics.
As far as I'm concerned, football and academics go hand in hand. It can be quite an adjustment for a freshman to come to the University of Wyoming and think that football will be taking 100% of his time. This might be true at some universities, but here the coaching staff will try to help you as much as they can to keep your academic life an important part of your life on campus. Football will teach you to budget your time, so in later life, you'll be able to adjust your schedules and therefore be able to make the most of your time. As far as I'm concerned, football is just a small part of my campus life. I'd like to continue my education with graduate work in psychology, specializing in shaping animal behavior.
The lessons learned at Wyoming are providing a strong base from which Mike LoPiccolo will launch a bright future. A guy who didn't know a football from a pineapple until he was in high school, Paul Nunu has come a long way, literally and figuratively. The sophomore native of American Samoa has found a place on the Polk defensive line and is in the top three in defensive totals. Size, strength, and agility are the tools Paul built into a starting position. He appears to be a fixture in the Cowboy defensive plans for the next two campaigns.
I signed with Wyoming because it is so different from any other place that I've been associated with. I feel that coming to Wyoming to play football and to go to school and at the same time trying to adapt to a new environment has helped me to be a better football player and to grow up as a person. Coming here on a scholarship has allowed me to do a lot of things that I wouldn't have been able to do at another place. Personally, I feel that right after high school, a guy should be on their own because it is important to be an individual.
The 1974 Cowboys were a young football team with only 12 seniors aboard. Many youngsters gained valuable experience, including a large number of one of the best freshman crops in years. The future indeed looks bright. These are some of the players who will carry the Cowboys over schedules that include Colorado, Air Force, Michigan State, LSU, among others, and of course, the ever-tough Western Athletic Conference. Andy Dixon, number 33, powerful running back from Champaign, Illinois. Robbie Wright, number 43, one of the Cowboys scoring leaders in 74, a junior from Newark, New Jersey. And, of course, Rick Costello, the daring young quarterback. Plenty of hands return to the defensive unit. Aaron Kyle, number 25, one of the finest cornerbacks in the WAC and the defensive point leader in 1974. He's a senior from Detroit. Number 20, the smallest cowboy of all, 5'7", 160-pound Carl Coleman of Memphis, Tennessee, a three-year veteran who missed the middle part of the 74 season with a knee injury, but he'll be back as a senior. Scott Fairclough, three-year letterman from North Syracuse, New York. Scott played both offense and defense in 74, but is more at home with the defensive unit. One of the top youngsters in the secondary is safety Kevin McLean, number 36 of Denville, New Jersey. Kevin will be a junior. Another of the talented newcomers in the secondary is junior-to-be Bill Baker, safety man from Oscoda, Michigan. Defensive quarterback is Randy Galoo, the left linebacker of Norfolk, Nebraska. One of the smallest but toughest middle guards in the league is Paul Duke, a senior from Littleton, Colorado. The excellent crop of freshmen produced these burly linemen: Leon Broussard, number 75 of Los Angeles, California, and number 76, Cliff Winfield of Perth Amboy, New Jersey. And one of the real cowboys on the squad, linebacker Carl Hansen of Fort Collins, Colorado, rodeos in the offseason. These are the men who hold the future to cowboy football. Youthful, talented, and determined. They are the ones who will put Wyoming back on the road to conquest.